Hello students, in this class we are going to see regarding the viral plant diseases, that is the virus which affect the plants resulting in the disease formation in the plant. Here we will see what is this viral plant diseases. Here there are about 300 viral diseases in plants. These are noted about 300 viral diseases in plants, mostly affects the crop plants, fruit plants and the vegetable yielding plants. These all together we found 300 viral diseases. Those are reported in the plants, especially in which? In the crop plants, the fruit plants and the vegetable yielding plants. Here the viral plant disease may be the systematic or local. Here we have the type, the that viral can affect in two types, that is in a systematic way or in a local way. Here we see what is the systematic infection here, which causes the disease spreads all over the plant through the vasculature. What happens here? If it is the leaf of plant, here in the systematic infection, the infection spreads all over the leaf. It infects whole leaf or the whole plant. Whereas in local infection, here the disease is restricted to the certain areas. See, if it is the leaf, this is in the case of local. This is restricted only to particular areas. This is in the case of local infection, whereas this is in the case of systematic infection. Here we got to know the virus that is responsible for the infection. That infection leads to the disease formation in the plant. Here we have the two types, that is the this disease may spread by the systematic or the local way. Under the systematic, here the complete disease spread all over the plant through the vasculature, whereas in the local, the disease is restricted to the certain areas. Here the area of disease spreading is more in systematic infection, whereas less in local infection, because systematic infection covers the maximum area, whereas the local, it is minimized to the specific area. Here the following are the some important symptoms of the viral plant diseases. These are the in general the important symptoms which we can analyze. Is the plant affected by the viral or the bacteria? Here we can differentiate based on the symptoms which the plant is showing. The first one is mosaic. Here the mixed light yellow and the green patches appear on the leaves, making a mosaic pattern. This is a systematic infection. The first one is the mosaic, where the mixed light yellow and the green patches appear on the leaves, making a mosaic pattern. And this is the systematic infection, means the complete plant and the leaves which infect by the viral diseases. The example for this mosaic is the TME, that is the tobacco mosaic virus. Next, the mosaic of cucurbitis. Next, the mosaic of the potato, and etc. These all the example for the mosaic infection. Next comes the aloes. Here the uniform chlorosis all over the leaf. It is also called the chlorosis diseases. Here we see the yellowing of the leaf, that is the chlorosis. The chlorophyll pigment get reduced, the green plant that turn to the yellow in case of the chlorosis, that is the yellows. Here the example is rice yellow. In case of the rice yellow, we see the yellows, that is chlorosis takes place. Next comes anentians. What happens here? The small hair like outgrowths appear on the leaves, called the anentians. These outgrowths often accompany mosaic symptoms. This is seen in the case of the been an ancient mosaic. What happens is first the small hair outgrowths appear on the leaves, which those are called as the anantians. These outgrowths often accompany the mosaic symptoms. This shows these kind of symptoms after the appear of the hair-like projection on the leaves. Example is bean anantian mosaic. Next comes the vein clearing, vein banding and vein thickening. These all takes place how veins and the veinlets become light yellow and transparent while the lamina remains normal. What happens here? In these cases, the veins and the veinlets becomes the light yellow and the transparent while the lamina remains the normal. It is in vice versa in vein banding, the whole lamina turns yellow. What happens in vein banding? Here, the whole lamina part turns to the yellow, whereas in vein clearing and the vein thickening, the vein and veinlets become yellow, but the lamina remains the normal. The example for vein clearing in lady's finger. Next comes the leaf curling or the leaf rolling. What happens here? The infected leaves that curl or the roll back. See, if it is the normal leaf, what it will do? It will roll back or it will curl. At the edge, it will curl. Here the example is the leaf curl of the papaya and the tomato. This is seen in papaya and the tomato. Next, little leaf. In this, the affected leaves become small and crowded, giving the rosette appearance. What happened here? Here the affected leaves become small. If it is particular size, which turns to be a smaller when we compare, when this is a symptom of viral attack. Here the example in brinjal, that is the little leaf of brinjal, again which shows here this is crowded, giving a rosette appearance. These leaves become small and crowded, giving the appearance of the rosette. Next comes the stunting. What happens here? The infected plants have over retardation of the growth. What happens here? The growth is minimized. That is, over retardation takes place. The best example is the bunchy top of banana. We seen in the bunchy top of banana, the normal size of the banana plant is reduced to a very small height. This is due to the stunting, that is the reduced of the height. Next comes the breaking and the greening of the plants. Here, the petals of the flowers that change the color become small and green and appear variegated. Sometimes it may enhance the beauty of the flower. Here, what happens here in the breaking and greening of the plants? The petals of the flowers that changes the color. Here, the petals of the flowers changes the color, become small and green in color. That petals loses its actual color, which turns to be a green and appear variegated. Sometimes it may enhances the beauty of the flower. In contrast, the normal color of the flower that turns to the green, sometimes it enhances the beauty of the flower. This is seen in broken tulip flower. The example is broken tulip flower. Next comes the formation of the tumors. Here, some viral infection that produces the tumors on leaves or on the roots. Here, tumors are formed where we can get the infectious cell of the viruses. Next comes the witch's broom. Here, leaves get reduced and also the internodes resulting in crowded clusters looking like a broom. This is in the witch's broom where what happens? The leaves get reduced. The leaves get reduced and also the internodes resulting in crowded clusters. See, if it is a plant, this is the node. This is the node, this is the node, this is the internode. This is crowded. crowded clusters. It like a crowded clusters looking like a broom. This is in the condition of which is broom. Those are the general symptoms where we can find the whether the plant that get infected by the viral. Here we will see the transmission of the plant viruses. We know the plant that get infected by the virus, but we have to know what are the modes that transmit the viral diseases in plants. Here the viruses are transmitted from plant to plant in a number of ways. See, if this is a healthy plant, if it is infected plant, this is the normal healthy plant, this is infected plant. What happens here? This infected plant can transfer the infection to the healthy plant also. As we know, in general we know, if we keep the healthy fruit with the infected fruit, what happens? Obviously, the resulting is the infection of the healthy fruit too. That is how the virus or the bacterial infection takes place from the infected to the normal one too. Here, the modes are the methods of the transmission, that either may be the transmission by the vegetative propagation, the condition may be transmission by vegetative propagation or by the seed transmission, the soil transmission, the transmission by the contact, the transmission by the smokers, transmission by insects, and the fungal transmission. Here we know the vegetative propagation, that is the mode of reproduction. This may be the case where the infected part is cut off or the breakdown from the parent body, which may infect the growing part of the parental body. That is transmission by the vegetative propagation. Next, seed transmission. First of all, we have to check whether that is seed we are growing that is free from the viral and the bacterial infection. If it is infected by either the viral or the bacterial, ultimately the plant that going to affect by these infections. Next, soil transmission. Before we testing the soil, whether we have to see what we planted first, that plant is disease free or which is affected by the disease. If it is the affect by the disease, the spores were commonly seen in the soil, they germinate again, they form the infection to the growing plant, that leads to the infection to the healthy plant. Next, the transmission by contact. If we touch a infected plant and we directly touch the normal plant, what happens here? The spores of the infected plant that get transferred to our hands to the normal plant. What happens there? Even the normal plant that get infected, that is by the contact. Here the transmission by the smokers. This is in tobacco. Whether we have to check the leaves those are using, whether they are free from the infection or they are infected. If those are infected, possibility of the spreading infection. Next, transmission by insect, that is during the pollination. If the insect that comes and sit on the infected plant and it goes to the normal plant, here this is the mode of infection, that is through the insect. Here insect that suck the nectar along with the spores, that is the infected spores that comes and sit on the healthy plant, where they again germinate and causes the diseases in plant, that is by the transmission by the insect. The last one is the fungal transmission. The transmission can take place by the fungal formation. These are the modes of transmission of plant viruses. Here in our syllabus they prescribe TMV, vein clearing, drafting, yellowing, and BBTV diseases. As we seen before, those are in general, but we are going to focus on tobacco mosaic virus, vein clearing, drafting, yellowing, and banana bunchy top diseases, which given in your syllabus. Here I shown you some pictures. Here we can identify the first one. This is in the case of TMV, that is the tobacco mosaic virus. See, this is systematic infection because complete plant and the leaf that is covered by the infection spots. This is TMV. This is in the case of vein clearing. See, yellowing of the vein and veinlets. This is in vein clearing and this is in drafting. See, difference between the normal plant and the infected plant. What happens here in drafting? Next, this is in yellowing. Here, chlorophyll is completely reduced, showing the yellow color formation. This is green due to presence of the chlorophyll, where we won't see the chlorophyll. Hence, turn the yellow. This is in yellowing. This is in the case of BBTV disease, that is the banana bunchy top diseases. Here, you see the height. This is completely drafted. Reduced, that is the stunted height. Normal plant that reduces is the height, that is the banana bunchy top diseases. Here we will see the first one, that is the tobacco mosaic virus. In short, we call it as the TMV. Here, tobacco mosaic is widely studied diseases of all the viral diseases. As we know, this is the popular disease we come across in the viruses. This occurs wherever the tobacco plant is grown. Where we find this disease, that is the tobacco mosaic virus, that is where the tobacco plant is grown or the cultivated. Here, TMV is known to infect more than 150 genera of mostly herbaceous dicots, including flowers and seeds, causing heavy damage for the tobacco and to a certain extent for the tomato also. Here, it mainly damages the tobacco plant. In small amount, it also infects the tomato plant. Here, we have the more than 150 genera that is affected by this tobacco mosaic virus. As we know, this is the structure. See, this is the hollow core. How these are arranged? This is the hollow cylinder where the capsomers are arranged. See, this is the how the structure is formed. See, this hollow core, that the radius measures about the 40 angstrom. Here, genetic material is RNA. RNA is the genetic material. These are the capsomers. The diameter of this TMV is 180 angstrom in diameter. This is the structure. Here, the virus. As we know, the virus is tobacco mosaic virus in tobacco plant. Here, the pathogen is a typical tobacco mosaic virus. It is rod shaped. The size is rod shaped. Its protein structure consists of about 2130 subunits. This 2130 subunits arranged helically, means spirally. Helically means spirally. Each subunit consists of 158 amino acids. Here, each subunit, those consist of 158 amino acids. The nucleic acid is a single-stranded RNA. Here, nucleic acid, that is the genetic material, is single-stranded RNA consisting of 6,400 nucleotides. Here, the number is 6,400 nucleotides. The TMV is highly thermostable and remains infectious in nature at the dilution of 1:1,000,000 in water. This is highly thermostable, that is the highly resistant to the temperature, and it remains in infection in the nature in the dilution of 1:1,000,000 in water. See, as we know, this is the central lumen, that is the RNA helix, and the capsomers. These capsomers are nothing but the protein subunits. See, This is single protein subunit. See, this is single protein subunit. This is regarding the virus. The virus is tobacco mosaic virus. Here, transmission. In the case of tobacco mosaic virus, what are the modes that takes place? Here, the transmission of TMV from unhealthy plants to the healthy plants mainly takes place by the means of the contact method. As I said before, here the transmission takes place by the unhealthy plants to the healthy plants mainly takes place by means of the contact method. Next, it is mostly carried by the workers working in the tobacco field, either on their hands or the clothing. It either may be case where it is transferred by the hands to hands or by the clothes where the workers are working in the field. Next, it is also transmitted by unburnt cigarettes and the bidis. This may be also the reason where transmitted by unburnt cigarettes and the bidis, which are infected before. Next, TMV seems to occur mainly in the cytoplasm as aggregates of the crystals or sometimes as the amorphous bodies in the different sizes. This may be the condition where TMV seems to occur mainly in cytoplasm. Next, TMV may also occur in nucleus, chloroplast, vacuoles, etc. Here, where this TMV is present, it either may be present in nucleus, chloroplast, or in the vacuoles also. This is how the transmission going to take place. Here, symptoms. What are the symptoms in TMV? Here, TMV becomes symptomless, especially on the grapes. When it affects the grapes, it won't show any of the symptoms which we seen here. Apples along with grapes and the apples too. But symptoms becomes very clear on tobacco causing characteristic mosaic symptoms. Here where we can see the clear characteristic features of the symptoms. This is only in the case of tobacco. Where in the case of grapes and the apples, even though it affected, we can't differentiate the infection part of the plant as we can do in the tobacco. On the young tobacco leaves, the veins may show clearing, which is usually followed by the mottling. Clearing and the mottling. Here, finally, dark green spots appear which develop into the blister-like areas and the tissues become more and more chlorotic. See, if it is the plant, first, what happens here? Clearing and the molting. Here the spot. Here and there the spot becomes which gets severe, where the dark spots appear, which turns to be a yellow in color, that is due to the chlorotic. Next, later the drafting of the entire plant occurs. The normal plant that get reduced to the drafting due to the effect of the viral plant. In rare cases, malformation also occurs. In some case, the malformation of the plant takes place. This is due to the effect of the virus. See, this is the normal healthy plant of the tobacco, whereas these are the infected plants. Here we can differentiate between the normal healthy plant and the infected plant. See, spots. See, these are the severe symptoms that we can differentiate between the normal healthy tobacco plant and the infected tobacco plant. This is the chlorosis. See, this is in the case of infected tobacco plant. Here, the physiology of the TMV infected plant. Here we need to check whether after the infection of the viral, whether the plant performs the same function it showing the before the infection. That we have to check. If we check, no. The normal plant that is performing before the infection, that completely changes its physiology after the infection. Here, the physiology of the TMV infected plant is completely affected. The first point, yes, it will get affected. It reduces the rate of photosynthesis. See, it reduces the rate of photosynthesis because it affects the chlorophyll pigment. Here we can see the yellow spots of the yellow spots where the infection takes place. Means yellow spots means there is the lack of the chlorophyll pigment. If the chlorophyll pigment varies, ultimately the photosynthesis also varies. By reducing the amount of chlorophyll, hence the quality of carbohydrate is reduced. As we know, if the rate of photosynthesis is reduced, obviously the carbohydrate is reduced. Because photosynthesis, where it synthesizes its own food, it is reduced, means the ultimate carbohydrate rate also reduced. Next, the TMB affects several enzymatic activities like the cytochrome oxidase, polyphenol oxidase, etc. Thus, the respiration is completely affected. What happens here? First, photosynthesis affects. Later, the respiration process also get affected due to the infection of the viral. Next, the most important content of tobacco leaves is, that is the nicotine. Why we cultivate tobacco? This is due to the presence of the nicotine. To extract the nicotine, most we go for the cultivation of the tobacco, where if it's infected, this percentage of nicotine present, that is reduced in infection plant compared to the normal plant. This affect in economical way, that is in the percentage of nicotine that get reduced, means the quality of plant is ultimately reduced. Next, if the plant is affected, then what are all the control measures? How we can control that infection? We will see here. Here, people working in the tobacco field should be avoid contamination by of the hands with the virus from tobacco plants. The first case is where the people working from the tobacco field should be avoid contamination of the hands with the virus from the tobacco plant. Cleaning of the hands with the soap between the operation is an effective means of the avoiding contamination. This is the important step where in the field or in the cultivated field. Here the worker should be taken care of washing their hands when they touches from one field to the other. We don't know whether that is the infection in the initiation, in the initiative time. We can't differentiate whether it is the infected or not. Hence, they have to give the care regarding the physical contact of the hand from touching one plant to the other. Next, eradication of the infected leaves. If the infected leaves are present, that has to be burnt. Here, seed beds should be sterilized by means of steam and well removed from the tobacco warehouses. While in the warehouses, here seed beds should be sterilized by the means of steam. There are n number of procedures where we can sterilize the warehouses. Here we can give the steaming. By giving the steaming, here we can minimize the possibility of the infection. Next, the disease can be controlled by using the resistant varieties. Here the resistant variety is emblema variety. In this variety, we can see even the plant is infected, it shows the minimized percentage of the affected diseases. This is due to the resistant varieties. Here the gene is, that is manipulated with the resistant gene, which shows the resistance power to the plant. This is the variety of resistant gene of the tobacco plant. Here in this, symptoms are mild. As I said, if it plant is affected, it also affected also it shows the mild infection parts, because which has the resistant gene against the tobacco mosaic virus. This is the regarding the control measures of the TMV. This is regarding the first one, that is the tobacco mosaic virus. In next class, we are going to see the second, what happens in vein clearing, vein loading and vein rafting. What are the symptoms and what are the procedure, how to control this infection, we will see in next class. This is for today. Thank you.